everyone, and welcome to Redbird Replay. This is Scott Kirker along with Colton Kaler. Colton, Metamora, tough loss last night, but and we've talked about this before. The nice thing about basketball is you get to come back 24 hours later and play again.
Yeah, definitely. You get a chance to bounce back, especially after a very bad loss last night to a good Pekin team, but overall it was just a really bad loss.
Yeah, that was a really bad one. But tonight we can change everything if we take care of business and beat Washington, our rival. Metamora comes into this contest with a 17-10 record. We're 7-4 in the Middle Illini Conference. And Washington, they're probably going to end up winning the conference, but Metamora will get a higher seed in their regional that we will host. We're about 2 minutes away from tip-off, Colton, this is as packed a house as we've had here in a while.
Yeah, this is we're at full capacity. They said they locked the doors. It's going to be a great atmosphere tonight between two really good teams. Redbirds have a chance to play spoiler here tonight. And it's no better of a chance to play spoiler than against a team like this.
No, it's not. And, this is a good chance for Metamora to kind of redeem themselves from last night and kind of set themselves up a little bit for the regional. It'd be awfully nice to get a win here in front of the big crowd, the home crowd. This is a big Metamora crowd here tonight.
Both sides will be loud and proud here tonight. It's this is, when you think of Metamora Washington, this is kind of what you think of right here.
Yeah.
Both teams travel well.
Yeah, not very far to go.
No.
And it's a little chilly out tonight. They had locked the doors. Why don't we take this time and talk to the Redbird head coach. Well, here we are once again with Metamora head coach Danny Greaves. Coach, last night a tough loss, but the best thing about basketball is you get to come back the next night and play again.
Well, you got to have a short memory. we haven't lost the war. We just lost that battle. And we got to get it, come right back in less than 24 hours and have a chance to go after our rival. So, yeah, it's going to be a fun night, I hope.
It's a fun night. You got a packed house. I don't remember them. Maybe a couple other times maybe where they announced that the building was at capacity. So,
all right.
Coach, you come out tonight. You're going to be without Landon Ivins. But I think you've got some kids that can start to kind of maybe fill in and take some, play some roles where, you're not going to miss Landon tonight.
Well, we've got, like I told him, it's next man up. That's what good programs do.
Yes.
And I think our guys know that, and I think they're ready for it. They've trained for it. So I'm looking forward to seeing, what guy's going to accept that next challenge.
Who will start tonight in place of him?
It's kind of a game-time decision. We're going to see who they're going to start, and we'll just go from there.
Okay. Coach, this is a big game. You're playing Washington. They're ahead of you in the standings. You still got a higher seed than they did in the regional seeding, so it is kind of a win. We're not a win-win, but you got a kind of a win over them.
Well, I tell you what, we played them tough after going down 18-2 over there. We don't play well on the road, obviously. Here a little bit in the upper echelon in the Middle Illini Conference, and so we're at home and we're going to give it our best shot.
Well, Coach, we'll let you get going here, but good luck and bring home a W.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it, guys.
Welcome back to Metamora. We're about 50 seconds away from the starting lineups and the national anthem. Colton, you got to believe that, a big crowd like this, Metamora is going to get off to a good start. You hope.
You would hope, because we've been getting off to about as bad of a start lately as you can draw up.
Boy, yeah, I don't know. We went 5.5 minutes last night and didn't score to start the game.
We went 0-for-8 in about 5 to 6 of those were, easy bunnies or layups. We got to move on.
We won't say any more about last night's game because it's about tonight's game. And this is our conference rival.
And who doesn't love a good rivalry game like this?
Yeah.
When you think of good rivalries, you think of Michigan, Ohio State, you think Cub Cardinals, and you think Metamora Washington.
Bear Packers.
Bears Packers, yep.
Changes in the lineup tonight. Caleb Kaiser will come off the bench. Of course, Landon Ivan's not available tonight. So Ryan Begol and Zach Schroeder both get the start tonight for the Redbirds. So we start a freshman, a sophomore, a junior, and two seniors.
Yeah. And there's
And they're still younger.
I think we have. There's two seniors on the floor. No, three. Three ball off the start. Good from Vanderhyke. So Washington out to an early 3-0 lead here in the first possession. Washington out in man. Redbirds really struggled last night with that zone. Klusky three ball. The answer, no. Good look. You know, Coach Greaves' spot last night that we gave a lot of guys looks. It would turn over there. That he didn't want to have looks. A layoff to Gabe Mason for the layup.
Oh, that's a nice dish by Klusky. Nice to see Gabe get off to a good start here. Was he at 18 points in the last three games?
I believe so, but that was all set up by Klusky as he, you know, convinced the defender that he was going in for the layup, and Gabe was trailing right behind, and he laid it off for an easy two-point layup. That's a beautiful play there from the senior. The thing is Washington is not very deep. They bring up a lot of sophomores and freshmen off their team, but last time we played Washington, they got into foul trouble early. There was a travel, yep.
Yep, that's a good job by Schroeder. That's real good defense by Metamora. Already you're seeing a little bit more intensity than we saw all last night.
Yeah. There gets a sub early for Drew Lewis as he had back-to-back turnovers. So that brings in 42.
We don't have him on the roster.
If it's 42 off of the sophomore team, Ethan Kaiser can't get it. Got a little contact there in the back there. We're going to go with Cameron Donald on 42. That's the number of the sophomore team. Three ball Vanderhyte, no. Rebound to Ethan.
That's a good check out by Kaiser. 3-2 Washington here in the early going.
Deep three, Kaiser, short. Washington's been doing a lot of scouting on Metamora lately. Mapson can't get it.
Nice rebound by Gabe Mace. That's a nice, strong rebound. Good defense there.
Great job by Ethan to wall up and not give Mapson the easy inside look. It was still a good opportunity to score. Can't knock it down, but Washington's coaches have been at almost every Metamora game for the last few weeks. Klusky, three. No. Klusky's going to have to shoot a little bit tonight with the absence of Ivins. Vanderhyte, that's banked in.
Oh, banked it in. That's cheap. Six-two Washington.
I expect the Redbirds to go a little deeper off their bench tonight. Go inside to Schroeder. Oh, he got held. Yep. Trying to get a foul on the floor.
That's a nice job by Schroeder. Catch the ball, then go to the bucket. That gets Caleb Kaiser up off the Redbird bench early, and he'll come in. He'll replace Ryan Begol. Redbirds need a bucket.
Oh, he traveled, yep.
Yeah. Gus Lucas into the Washington Panther lineup. Six-two Washington.
They're going to go inside to Lucas. He traveled.
Yeah, oh, they're charge. Getting a charge.
Clearing him out with the elbow. It's even better. Get a foul picked up there. Third Panther turnover.
Is that the biggest student section you've seen at Metamora?
Definitely in a while. I think probably one of the most fun and one of the largest student sections I've ever been a part of was my freshman year here against Washington. That was Nate's senior year. They also had Lou Griffith, a three ball here from Schroeder. No, that should be, yep, that's Washington ball.
Still 6-2.
Gonna get 20, Tyler Bass up off the bench. Gus Lucas inside, easy two.
Makes it 8-2. We're starting to dig ourselves another one of those holes.
Yep. Well, we're not hitting our outside shots. Rippers really haven't shot the three ball well lately in these last couple of games. We're taking too many forced shots like that one right there.
That's a nice rebound though by.
That's a deep contested look that you really don't want. Gonna get it on the floor. That's gonna be Gus Lucas's second. And so that'll get Mapson back up for him.
Send Gabe to the line for two.
That was on the floor. They called it before the shot.
Oh. Ooh.
That was the right call. He bumped him before he was really, when he was driving in the lane.
I like seeing that though. He struggled a little bit from outside, so he's going to the bucket.
I think Coach Grease is going to have to go to his young guys a little bit tonight. He's probably going to have to go to the Luke Doty's, and they're speaking of Luke Doty right there.
Yep.
That's a jump. That's a jump. Yep.
Jump ball, and that'll be Redbird ball. That's a good call. Luke Doty replaces Nate Klusky.
Schroeder met him. Causes the jump ball. Actually, it was close because if that hand gets on top of the ball, that can be called a travel.
Oh, love that move. That's a really nice, good baseline move by Gabe.
Great design play there. They're probably that's a look where they're trying to get the three, but it leaves up that open chance if you can get around your defender to the baseline, which is exactly what Gabe did, because they're overplaying him, expecting the three. Mapson three. No good. And he misses the layup.
Nice strong rebound by Caleb Kaiser. Redbirds have a chance to cut. They've already cut it in half. It's 8-4.
It's too close of a pass.
That's a good job by Gabe just to keep the possession.
Jump ball possession back to Washington. A little too much dribbling there.
Yep.
Got to keep the fluid ball movement.
Eight-four the score. 1:44 to go, first quarter. Redbirds trail.
Oh, he traveled.
Traveled, yeah.
That's the fifth Panther turnover.
Nice job.
It was last year where Joe Nealon and Peyton Havens dropped a couple of guys doing that.
Yep.
We had one here this year against Manuel.
And they
called the foul when, I don't know what you want to call a foul in.
Ooh.
They're going the other way. Illegal screen.
Well, under a minute to go, 57 seconds. Redbirds trail 8-4.
Oh.
Yeah.
Probably so. It just. I'll get Begol back up off the bench.
Sends Drew Lewis to the line for two. He did a great job staying up, but a little body contact. That's a tough one there. Because he did almost everything he could.
Nice rebound by Begol.
He's got to be over the back there.
37 seconds to go. First quarter. Oh, that's a foul.
Oh,
yeah.
It's the second on Donald. So fourth Panther foul.
Seconds. Yep, there's a hold. He hits first.
His first team fifth.
6.1 seconds to go, first quarter. Redbird's got to get a good shot here.
Yep.
Oh, they're calling a foul. And that'll send Doty the line for a two-shot foul. He went right at him. I like that. That's two quick fouls on Lewis now.
Now Redbirds will be in the bonus for the entire second quarter.
Boy, I like the way he went right at him.
Well, he didn't have much of a choice. This
Come
is
on,
a
Luke.
First. Last night we didn't shoot free throws until, what, the third quarter?
We got the second, makes it 9-5. Redbirds will have the ball after the quarter break here, but a little bit better than last night. Take this time to thank our sponsors, Commerce Bank, Metamora McDonald's, Snyder Village, Goodfield State Bank, Ipavia State Bank, Zobershire Insurance, Germantown Grill, Kevin Kyle at Edward Jones, Mason Funeral Home, and Michael's Italian Feast.
MTCO digiMAX. We work hard to give our community the best value in internet, TV, and voice. But the big network conglomerates we have to pay for TV content don't share our community values. Every year, they demand higher and higher fees and force us to pay for channels few people watch. We hope you'll understand we're doing our best to keep our costs down and your rates low. Visit TVOnMySide.com to learn more about these unfair charges.
Well, Colton, Gabe's got four.
Yeah.
Luke Doty's got one. And other than that, we haven't really broken the scoring column yet. You know, Kaiser, Ethan Kaiser's going to get his, and we're going to get a couple other guys that are going to get some points too. And, you just got to get off that snide a little bit.
Washington's playing really tight defense right now. And, you know, we love to shoot the three ball as well as anybody else. And so we're not going to get the open looks that we want. And we're not really, you know, that strong of an offensive team. Or, well, strong offensive. Well, offensively in the post. You know, we're not going to, you know, just post guys up all day and, you know, it's going to be a layup fest. You know, we're a fast-paced style offense. Good look there from Ethan.
Well, that's sophomore to freshman, Ethan Kaiser with his first two of the night, 9-7 Panthers. Man, that's a nice bucket. I think that's open all night long. Oh, good
defense from Doty. Oh, they're going the other way.
Yep, an illegal screen, and that'll put, I think, is that some Schroeder? Player control foul, yep. Redbirds have a chance to tie it or take the lead.
You know, I think sometimes we try and settle too many times for a forced deep look. You know, we've got to look for that mid-range shot. You know, I know we focus a lot on another mid-range floater. Can't get that one to go. Oh, he traveled.
Oh, he traveled. Yes. That's a nice job. Gabe really went hard to the bucket, and it was just a little bit of contact, and that threw him off balance.
If anything, it was his own guy knocking him over. Trying to get Klusky and Guth up.
Ooh. Klusky and Guth, they'll come in, they'll replace Doty. Nice minutes by Doty, and they'll replace Schroeder also. Quality minutes by both of them.
Schroeder ended with what, 31 tonight?
At the sophomore game, yeah.
Yes.
Big win by the sophomores.
Had Bagol right there. Deep one from Gabe. It's off. Oh, he traveled again. Oh, my. Mapson misses another one. Going to get the body contact.
Yes.
On Mounts.
That's a nice drive, too. Boy, we haven't seen Ryan Bagol. He's been injured a lot this year. We haven't seen him have a chance to really do that.
That was, you know, and when there was many times last night where if he took that extra dribble, he had that exact look he just had right here. This time he takes the extra dribble and hits the first.
9-8 Panthers have a chance to tie it up here. And man, rolls out. 9-8 Panthers.
If that's not the epitome of the last few weeks, I don't know what is. There's another illegal screen airballed. That's going to be a foul on Guth. So I'll send Newkirk to the line for a pair.
We've got to do a better job boxing out. We've got to do a better job.
Well, I think we had the box out there, but I don't think we're expecting an air ball from Vanderheit there.
Yeah, but if you've boxed him out, he's not going to get to that point. Good foul.
Clanks the first. Building the foundation on that one.
Gets the second, 10-8 Panthers. Again, we have a chance to tie or take the lead.
Three ball, Klusky, got
good! The Redbirds lead 11-10. Oh, the two Panthers fall all over each other.
Third time's the charm there for Klusky.
Yes, that's a big bucket. It's the first time we've led in what, five quarters?
Yeah.
Well,
Mounts deep one, short. It's going to be Redbird ball.
5:18 to go. Second quarter, Redbirds up by one, 11-10.
Ball, Ethan, no.
Well, that's a good job by Guth and Ryan Bagul, both battling for that rebound, kept it alive, and they got it.
Crossover from Bagul with a block and
yes,
one.
And one.
Ryan Bagul. Basket's good. What a move. Nifty little crossover he had there. That's on Mounts, his second. I don't know if Mounts was too deep because he looked pretty set there.
Maybe he wasn't square. Yeah, you're right. Oh, man. 13-10 Redbirds.
I look to my right and there's a little kid asleep next to here in a gym like this. I don't know how you can be sawing some logs. Big time rivalry game here in Metamora.
Coming up on 4 minutes to go. Second quarter, Redbirds up 13-10.
Backdoor cut. Oh, great job to wall up. Mapson gets
that's
it.
That's a pretty good play there.
It's a good look.
13-12 Redbirds.
That's a good set play there from the Panthers. Got to be stronger with the ball. And the Redbirds turn it over. Sounds like a broken record, but it's, you can't allow him to just take your cookies like that. Luke Doty back in the lineup. He replaces Ethan. Just got to be stronger than that.
Well, they've got to spread out. .320 to go. Redbirds up 13-12.
If they want to waste time, you're the ones losing here. This is honestly one of the most annoying things about high school basketball right here. This is why high school needs a shot clock. And you know, the counter argument is, oh, you know, you should just play defense and get, it's, if you have, you know, no intent to play offense, you know, it's, you're not rewarding anyone.
We're giving us a chance to kind of rest a little bit.
Exactly.
I don't understand the strategy on this.
Thank you.
1 minute to go here in this first half, and Washington's already run off about 2 minutes just standing there. Goal and Vanderheide were battling pretty good over there. Did you see that?
No.
They had a foul again. Eleven seconds to go. First half, Redbirds up 13-12.
Didn't get it off.
No, they didn't count it.
He didn't
get it off. That's unbelievable.
They didn't get it off.
No.
Still in the hand.
Still in his hand. We'll be back in just a few minutes with the end of the first half stats
and the second half.
MTCO digiMAX, we work hard to give our community the best value in internet, TV, and voice. But the big network conglomerates we have to pay for TV content don't share our community values. Every year, they demand higher and higher fees and force us to pay for channels few people watch. We hope you'll understand we're doing our best to keep our costs down and your rates low. Visit TVOnMySide.com to learn more about these unfair charges.
Welcome back to Metamora. We'll go ahead with the halftime stats. Redbirds take a 13-12 lead into the halftime locker room. This is about as mid-Illini basketball, when you think about it, as it gets. You know, low-scoring game, defense, but Washington wasted the last 3 minutes and 30 seconds for a basket that didn't count at the buzzer. It's a tough way for them to end the half. They were visibly upset that the basket didn't count. But, you know, when you waste the last 3 minutes and 30 seconds like that, you know, that can happen. Redbirds were led by Gabe Mason with 4 points. Gabe had the 2 layups, took one shot in the second quarter. Even Kaiser with 2, Luke Doty with 1, Nate Klusky with a 3, and Ryan Begol, who I thought had probably one of the most impressive second quarters overall first half, as he had 2 great takes of the basket. One he got fouled on, hit one of the 2 free throws, and then the other one had an and one, but he missed the free throw. For the Panthers, they are led by Devin Vanderheit. He hit 2 threes in the first quarter. One of them was banked in, so luck was on his side there. Mapson with 2, Drew Lewis with 1, Dane Newkirk with 1, and Gus Lucas with 2. Panthers got a little bit of foul trouble, though. Donald, Lucas, Mounts, and Lewis all have 2 fouls. Redbirds' Caleb Kaiser has 2 fouls as well. We'll be back in just a little bit with the second half.
The delay tactic kind of backfired on the Washington Panthers a little bit. I think it was the right call. The ball was still in his hand.
Yeah.
When he went up for the dunk and the lights were on around the board. Mm-hmm.
It's, you know, when you, karma, I guess. Yep. You know, when you waste the last 30 minutes, you really don't let the players play. You know, Curly Boo Johnson's on my Twitter right now saying, you gotta let the players play. You know, you can't just sit there and, you know, waste time. And that's the biggest argument for why, you know, high schools need a shot clock, you know, 35, 40 second shot clock, because of something exactly like that. It just takes everything out of the game.
We're about 15 seconds away from the start of this second half.
The Washington ball to start the second half. They'll have Mounts, Lewis, Bass, Vanderheit, and Mapson out on the court. Redbirds bring out Schroeder, I think. Yep, Schroeder. Both Kaisers, Gabe and Klusky. So here we go. They're going to go inside the Mapson, and he gets it.
Pretty good entry pass from
Very good entry pass.
14-13 Panthers.
He left it up for Mapson to go get it. Looked almost like a too long of a pass at first, and maybe Ethan was going to be able to recover. Oh, right there, wide open. Ethan Kaiser, and the basket.
And that basket's good, and it'll be a foul. And it'll send Kaiser to the line for the and one. He took one kind of in the bad spot there, but give him a minute to get his breath. And
kind of a cheap one there from Mapson.
Redbirds take the lead back 15-14. Boy, he was wide open underneath. That was a nicely run play. His brother found him.
Yeah, a lot of congestion there over on the right side. And Ethan was able to get free and left about as wide open of a look as you can ask for, and he converts the 3-point play.
Gives Redbird the 2-point lead, 16-14.
Probably going to look to Mapson here again. There they go. Throws it up. Schroeder. No one could get the rebound. Mapson again got it. Just allowing a free basket right there by not being able to grab a defensive rebound. Too many second chance points.
Ties it up at 16.
Schroeder is fouled.
I like that going to the bucket. I like that.
Is that the fourth on Mounts? No, that's the third. Oh. So that was the first foul on Maps, and then the third on Mounts. Ooh. Schroeder misses the first.
Gets the second, gives us the 17-16 lead. 6:50 to go, third quarter.
River's not doing the best job of hitting their free throws tonight. It looks like, you know, we're leaving, you know, some short ones going 50-50. Oh, good
nice
defense
job
there from Gabe. That's off. No, ooh.
Yeah, it went off Klusky's leg.
I thought it went off the leg
foot
of 42.
That was great defense by Gabe to sneak through there, and it took away that handoff.
Yep.
If you're gonna take a charge, you gotta give it some the.
'18-17. Again, too much dribbling in traffic right there.
Redbirds will retain possession, but you didn't want that there.
No.
6 minutes to go, third quarter.
What we can't do is let the frustration sit in like we did last night. You gotta take matters into your own hands and try and flip the script and turn the game around. Travel, yep.
'18-17 Washington's lead.
Schroeder
nice job
says, get that out of here.
Oh, Babson he pushed,
going,
yes.
Yep, pushed.
Number two on Mapson.
Third Panther foul. Mapson's got all 6 points for the Panthers. Lewis and Mapson with the only shot attempts here for the Panthers in the second half. Ethan pulls it back, and he's going to get fouled.
He'll get 3 free throws. That's, what, the third time in the last 2 games that's happened?
So Bass, his 4th.
Ooh.
Or no, his 2nd, team 4th, excuse me.
Gets the first.
Schermerhorn is not happy, but he's gotta allow him to land. Bass has gotta allow Ethan to land.
Oh boy, I climbed in.
Ethan was he was bent over hoping everything for that one to go in there.
Some body English there. Gives us the lead, 19-18. 5:08 to go, third quarter.
And
he gets all 3.
So last night, he got fouled on a 3, hits all 3, does the exact same thing tonight.
That was a nice job by Ethan Kaiser to not let him get set up.
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
did he?
Yeah. Yep. Yep.
447, Redbirds up by two, 2018. It's the first. Ryan Bagol set to check in. He'll check in for Kaiser.
I think if he, I don't know, that's a tough one for Caleb to decide on what he wants to do, but he moved into Lewis. And that's where they're going to get the body contact. Oh, Gus Lucas just pushed off a cluster, Ethan. So 2019 Redbird lead after the missed free throw.
Oh, nice.
Klusky, three ball. Got
good!
It! Nate Klusky.
That's his second three of the night. That was a huge one. That was a nice play by Schroeder to get him a wide open look in the corner.
Great head fake from Schroeder, thinking his defenders are getting Bagol.
Ooh. Ooh. He fought through that. Yeah. 23-19 Redbirds. Largest lead of the night. Oh, nice help side.
It's got to be 3 seconds in the lane. Vanderheide was camped in there for the longest time.
...23-21 Redbirds.
Klusky thought about it. Gets that one. Oh, doesn't go in. Bagol with the rebound.
Big rebound by Ryan Bagol.
Second chance opportunity. Schroeder drive. Easy layup.
Good!
Line. 25-21 Redbird lead. 3:25 to play.
Kaiser was just getting
that's going the other way on Vanderheide.
Yep. Washington will take a timeout. Redbirds up 25-21. 3:22 to go in the ball in the third quarter. Excuse me, third quarter.
It's a 30-second timeout.
Nice job. They're going to get Washington with a hold.
On 20, Bass, his third.
And we're in the bonus from here on out.
Yep. Not sure.
He grabbed a hold of Bagol when he came across the baseline there, but I didn't think he were going to catch it. Or he traveled, yeah, he did. Oh, out of bounds, Redbird ball.
Yep. It's a quick visit for Andrew Coker there.
Yeah, he just got a cup of coffee, didn't he? Yeah. 25-21 Redbirds. Oh, he traveled again. Yep.
Got to put it on the floor first. It don't allow you to take a step. Even if your back pivot foot doesn't move, it seems like...
It looks like he's traveling.
It does, and it's being called a lot more now often, especially in high school basketball. He's getting Bagol. Vanderheide's holding Bagol. Bagol's just trying to fight for, position. Redbird's third.
Oh, that's double dribble, isn't it?
No, I think a gather is what they're going to classify that one as. The gather dribble, Vanderheide three. No, that's got to be over the back. I don't know how there was not over the back there on Gus Lucas.
Luke Doty comes in for Nate Klesky. They have a chance to close within one. 1:56 to go, third quarter. They missed a couple shots down there. You got to get the rebound. They're making their free throws, man. We got to do a better job at that.
Mapson with 9 points here in the third quarter. And they're getting Mapson with a foul, his third.
And that'll send Ethan Kaiser to the line for a one and bonus. They've got quite a few guys with three fouls already, don't they?
Yeah. Bass, Mapson, and Mounts all with three.
And the first one's up and good. It's a big free throw for Kaiser. 26-24. Gets a second. 27-24 Redbirds, 1:48 to go, third quarter.
Boy, Schirmerhorn likes to get his 2 cents in with the ref almost on every call. Good defense from Schroeder. Allow a slip it. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you got Luke Doty.
You gotta do your best to stay off there.
Rolled out, good foul.
Lewis might have one of the flattest free throws I've seen all year.
Yeah, it's about 10 and a half feet off the ground is all it is. Where you're really gonna have to do a good job boxing out because Washington's they're crafty underneath.
Yeah.
Gets the second, 27-25 Redbirds.
Need a bucket. At least a foul to get a trip to the free throw line. Got the bucket.
That's a nice drive to the bucket. Pulled up, and banked it in. That was nice, 29-25.
I think he lost Redbirds. His handle a little bit, but he was able to regain it and just kind of throw up a little floater, banks it in. Gabe doing a great job of battling inside with Gus Lucas.
Oh!
That's off Lucas.
No, it's off Gabe. It's off
Gabe. Was it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Gabe got one of those long arms on it. That's great job by Gabe.
Oh.
Oh.
My goodness. I don't know what more Gabe can do. Ooh.
Oh, good rebound by Gabe. Oh, man.
Need some help. Need someone come get the ball.
You're too far. That's the end of the quarter. That's a great job by Metamora. Good defense. Redbirds will take a 29-25 lead into the fourth.
Sloppy finish.
Too long of a pass there, but.
That was never the pass to make to begin with.
Probably not. Take this time to thank our sponsors, Commerce Bank, Metamora McDonald's, Snyder Village, Goodfield State Bank, Ipavia State Bank, Zober Shire Insurance, Germantown Grill, Kevin Cowell at Edward Jones, Mason Funeral Home, and Michael's Italian Feast. Expanded our lead by three. We won that third quarter, won the second quarter.
Yeah, you gotta just, you know, break it up in your 8 minutes. Redbirds are kinda, they're in the driver's seat here a little bit. They've got a couple of guys for Washington in foul trouble. Really the only one for the Redbirds in foul trouble is Caleb, and he checked in, so he'll start this fourth quarter. Bagol gets a rest.
Nice minutes from Bagol. Redbirds come out with Doty, Kaiser, Mason, and Schroeder. It'll be Washington ball to start this fourth quarter. Oh, they're getting Kaiser. They're getting Kaiser because he got his hand caught up in there, and Vanderhyde just, oh man.
That's a cheap one. You're looking for that one.
It'd be a one in bonus now for Washington.
If you want to call that, it's got to be called every single possession because that's exactly what's happening.
That'd be the fourth on Kaiser. That's a tough one. First one's up and good. 29-26. Gets them both, makes it 29-27. And a 1-3-1.
Gotta move the ball quick. Gabe wide open.
Oh, nice job by Bagol. What a job.
Gabe's just gotta learn to go up with it. I get it. He's trying to get the foul, but he's gotta learn just to go up with that the first time. Ethan Kaiser, three ball, no good. So Washington will have a chance to tie it or take the lead. Good offensive possession there from the Redbirds. Just gotta finish that layup. Ethan. Nope, Bagol. Yep. Thought he pointed at Ethan.
be Metamora ball. Puskey replaces Schroeder. .6:35 to go in the ball game. Redbirds up by two.
Ethan Kaiser, three, no. Shuffle his feet a little bit.
Oh, what? I think Begol thought he was going to get a foul called on him.
Oh, he traveled there. Are you kidding me? You're calling a foul on that? He's out of control, throwing up a circus shot from his knees. That's unbelievable.
.5:59 to go in the ball game. Redbirds up two. Vanderheide on the line for two. Misses the first. He's missed two in a row now. Well, Washington's in the double bonus now from here on out. We're in just the regular bonus. Cam's the second, 29-28 Redbirds.
Take their first timeout. Chance to regroup ourselves here.
Metamora's going to have to be strong with the ball, hit their free throws.
Yep.
Comes out with Begol, Klusky, Doty, Ethan Kaiser, and Gabe Mason.
Now they come out in man, which is, I think, probably what the Rebels would prefer.
Oh.
My goodness.
Schroeder will replace Doty.
There's Mapson to clean up. He misses.
Gabe Mays with a big rebound.
Gotta get Gabe involved somehow offensively. Schroeder.
That's nice. That is nice. Great pass by Klusky. What a nice play by Schroeder also. 31-28 Redbirds.
No, he didn't travel. That was good. Drew Lewis three ball.
Ties it up at 31. 4:49 to go in the ballgame. They call that a charge, but when we stand there. All tied up at 31, 4:32 to go.
just too easy. We have some of the worst post defense, I think.
Yeah, we have no post defense.
Yeah. Go up.
Yeah, there you go.
Tough
nice
shot,
job.
Gets it to go.
33 all, 3:55 to go in the ball game, all tied up at 33.
I gotta agree with that one. Gabe didn't get there. He just kind of slid in. And
yeah, but it's tough to tell from this angle if he's throwing that arm. It's gonna send Gus Lucas to the line for two.
First one's up, no good.
Somehow the Panthers have done a phenomenal job of not fouling this quarter.
Oh, climbed in, 34-33 Panthers. Got to get a bucket here. Got to get a bucket.
Getting double technicals.
Is that technical or double fouls?
I don't know. He might be getting double fouls. Yep, double foul. On Gabe and Mapson. That hurts them more than it hurts us because that's the fourth on Mapson. Yet another, well, not a turnover essentially for the Redbirds. Feels like one. They're going to get Caleb back up into the game. Caleb will replace his brother, Ethan. I mean, we have played the entire time where they've been allowing everything, and now they're going to start calling ticky-tack? My goodness. They're trying to give us every opportunity here.
Ethan returns, replaces Bagol. Good minutes from Bagol. Second one climbs in, 35-33 Redbirds.
Got to find a way to score a basket somehow. We're getting Vanderheit with a foul, so that'll send Caleb to the line for one and bonus.
Need these baskets bad. Need them. Got the first. That's a good one. It's a big one. 2:57 to go in the ball game. Redbirds trail by one, 35-34.
Rinse and repeat right here.
Rattled in and out.
Oh, he traveled. He traveled. He traveled. He traveled.
It's just another missed call right there. We change pivot foots. Kowalski three, need it. No. He's going to get a foul.
Well, that's a good job by Kleski to battle
I think,
there.
I think Caleb got lucky not to get called for over the back.
Yep.
So the Redbirds will be in double bonus from here on out.
Come on, you got to make the free throws.
Got the second, 37-35 Washington, 2:10 to go in the ball game. Panthers.
Get it. They're going to get a foul.
That's a pretty good battle by Schroeder there. That's a pretty good battle.
They're going to get 40 Vanderheit, his third and 10th.
1:34 to go.
Got to make the free throws.
First one's up and good.
The goal replaces Caleb. Caleb has four. Play a little offensive defense type scenario here between the two of them.
Gets them both, 39-37. Washington will take a timeout. Got to find a way to get a stop here, Colton. Got to get a stop. So it'll be Washington's ball after the timeout.
Possession arrow is with the Redbirds.
That's big.
Klossy's got to stay back. Oh, we got to try and take a charge there.
Yep.
That was your opportunity. He's using his arm to get past him. Bagol, take the charge. Take the charge, son.
Take the charge.
It's a fourth on Lewis.
Needs them both. Well, first one's up and good. 41-38. Two, three, Got the second, 41-39.
Klusky sink.
Washington takes a timeout. 42 seconds to go in the ball game, down two. Gotta find a way to get a turnover.
Yeah.
Gotta get a turnover. Trying to pick up a charge, maybe got to do.
Yeah, got to try and either take a charge or maybe foul and hope they miss one of two, get a three. I mean, you got to do a lot. The best would either be for them to throw it away or to get a steal. Be the first on Ethan Kaiser. That might be the guy who you want to foul.
Makes the first. It's a 3-point ball game. 42-39. 32 seconds to go. You go for three and tie and go overtime, or do you just try to get a two and then?
I think it right now, you'll take whatever you can get.
You find a way, don't you? You just find a way.
Four timeouts, why don't you use one?
Missed the second, 4-point lead, 19 seconds to go. It'll be Metamora ball. That's just, you can't have that. We find ways to lose, don't we?
Yes. Yeah.
Seconds to go. Redbird down by four. Wow.
Hope and pray for a miracle.
8.2. Send Gabe to the line for two. Of course he misses.
Can never make it easy on ourselves. Comes down to not doing the little things correctly.
Nope, and down the stretch, you know, you're just not mentally tough enough to, you know, not have turnovers and hit the free throw. We've done a pretty good job in the free throw department, but, you know, we just don't take care of the ball. We just, you know, throw lazy passes. And,
or just stupid passes that aren't there.
Yeah.
Just not doing the little things correctly. Comes back to bite you in a big way.
That's why we have so many close losses. Good enough to be close, not good enough to win.
Exactly.
Well, this will push Metamore's record to 17-11. They'll be 7-5 in the Mid-Illini Conference. Very disappointing.
Yeah, very disappointing. The only positive, I mean, I don't even know if it's positive, but the, you know, when we made our postseason run, we finished middle of the pack there, kind of towards the Mid-Illini. Didn't have a great regular season. It's after Canton next week, it's a new season. So time to refresh and get ready for hopeful a long postseason.
Washington will come away with a 5-point win. Probably the better team.
Yeah, I mean, just, again, down the stretch, Redbirds really just lost it. That's what it comes down to right there. Just didn't take care of the ball and didn't handle business how we should have.
Nope. We'll be back in a little bit with frustrated head coach Danny Greaves.
MTCO digiMAX. We work hard to give our community the best value in internet, TV, and voice. But the big network conglomerates we have to pay for TV content don't share our community values. Every year, they demand higher and higher fees and force us to pay for channels few people watch. We hope you'll understand we're doing our best to keep our costs down and your rates low. Visit TVOnMySide.com to learn more about these unfair charges.
Welcome back to Metamora. We're here with head coach Danny Greaves. Coach, another tough one to swallow here tonight at home against the Panthers. I thought we played a more well-rounded ball game than we did last night, but down the stretch, just couldn't convert on our opportunities.
Well, that's a good way to put it, you know. And when you get opportunities, you got to take advantage of them. I think we missed 5 free throws in that fourth quarter. You know, and you got to make plays down the stretch. And we fumbled the ball a little bit and missed free throws and lost a couple of assignments. But you know what? Our kids did everything they could, I thought. as far as effort goes. They left it all out on the floor. We didn't play our best, and we just got to get better. The good thing is, you know, the war is still on. We just lost the battle. You know, and I put it in terms of, you know, we want to try to get better every game. We still have a one-game regular season left. And, you know, it'd be nice to win three games in a row and get a regional championship. But we still have to do that one game at a time, and we got senior night next Friday night with Canton.
Well, I mean, you know, I thought our guys responded pretty well, you know, for being a man down tonight. You know, some fresh faces seeing out there, Bagol in the starting lineup. Luke Doty saw quite a bit of time, and I thought, you know, at times that, you know, they showed a little bit of, you know, not experience, but at times, you know, they showed some promise.
Yeah, they did. They manhandled us inside a little bit. We've got to play stronger in the post. You know, they came right out the second half and took it at us. We got our first foul in the first 6 seconds. And we just got to do a better job with our interior defense.
You know, we were down three there towards in the stretch. I think there may have been less than a minute or so. We tried to drop a play for Ethan there on the right wing.
Right.
And he gets back to Bagol, and then he tries to make a pass and turns it over. Was there ever a thought of taking a timeout there? Or was it kind of try and catch him on their heels and see where it goes?
Well, we were trying to score and then get a timeout. We had the set play. It was the right play. It was open. The pass was just a little bit errant. But, you know, we've just got to do a better job of taking care of the ball. I mean, we had it right where we wanted with who was going to get it, and we didn't execute it.
You know, can't fault the effort. We did everything. Ethan, you know, didn't have his best shooting performance night, but he got it done at the free throw line, a perfect night from the free throw line. Schroeder, you know, I thought he's bounced back well, you know, put up 9 points after he, you know, had a big night in the sophomore game. Just game's been a little quiet here as of late, and got to try and find, you know, something to get him going.
Well, he has, but if you take a look, I mean, they're trying to do a really good job of not letting him even catch. Mm-hmm. But I was very pleased with his ability to do a couple other things. You know, he set some great screens all night long and got beat up a little bit doing it. And so, you know, what I liked is he didn't just stop playing because he wasn't getting his shot off. But sometimes that's going to happen because, you know, he's a prolific scorer, and, you know, the other team's going to try to take that away. So I was proud of him doing some other things tonight other than just trying to shoot the ball.
Well, that will do it for us here tonight. Coach, we got one more home game. I guess, you know, the best way to put it is, you know, after next week, next Friday night, senior night, you wipe everything clear. Regular season doesn't matter. You just got postseason now. It's do or die.
Well, I told our guys if I had to take one team out of the 10 that was in our subsection, that I'd want to go into battle with, it'd be mine. And if there was one team that I wouldn't want to have to play with our backs to the wall, it'd be mine. And so with that being said, you know, I still got a great love with our guys on what they can do, and I've got great confidence that we're going to pull it out. So, you know, we got one game at a time. We've got senior night with Canton. Should be a great night, always a good crowd for senior night. And then the regional starts. The play-in game is on Monday. Then the number one team will play them on Tuesday, and we'll play on Wednesday. So we've got some really good basketball left, but we're still going to take it one game at a time. We want to finish this middle line off.
Well, the best way to put it is in the regional, we'll have home court advantage. We'll have to defend that, and it's not an easy place to come in here and try and knock us off, especially with our backs against the wall.
Well, hopefully we'll shoot a little better, and that'll help us being home.
Well, that will do it for us here tonight, Coach. We'll see you next Friday night for senior night. We'll see you next week.
Sounds good. Appreciate you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you. That will do it for us. We'll see you next Friday at home against Canton for senior night on the Redbird Replay.